Welcome, race fans. I'm Chris Nisley, and we're here at Purdue's Grand Prix track for the inaugural Electric Vehicle Grand Prix. Get ready, it's gonna be one for the history books.
This Electric Vehicle Grand Prix is an electric go-kart race. It's originally started for a way for the students to show off what they've learned. We have a couple of electric vehicle classes being started. It's an offshoot of a $6.1 million grant from the DOE for electric vehicle education in our colleges. The EV Grand Prix program is initially to teach students how to build electric vehicles. I mean, we're gonna have electric vehicles in the marketplace in the near future, and people need to know how to A, build them, and B, work on them. That's what this program's all about. So hopefully we're gonna have people that are more educated in specifically this field to work on these cars in the design research labs and in the basic mechanic shops to get yours fixed.
Can you tell us how one of these electric vehicles works?
Sure, we'll start out with the batteries. These are lithium iron phosphate batteries. They're very similar to the batteries you have in your cell phones. They're a little different in chemistry, but they work the same way. You discharge them by driving the cart, and you go home and plug them in at night, and in the morning they're all charged for you. This right here is our National Instruments wireless node. It sets up a wireless network, so we beam the data from the cart to the team so they can analyze it when they're trying to tune and test and see what's working and what's not working. It sends power readings through volts and amps, and they can graph that in real time during any event or any test activity they're doing. The most important thing on the back here is this. It's called a controller. It is like the brain. So when you hit the gas pedal, it tells the batteries how much electricity to send to the motor to make it spin. And we can program it, plug it into a computer, and graph exactly how much power goes into it, how much doesn't, depending on how hard you hit the pedal. Next is the part everyone wants to see, is the electric motor. This is the beef and the brawn. This is called a setbex motor. It's really neat. So the piece inside that moves and rotates and the shell around it have different charges, so it can produce an awesome electric field to really push you out of the corners and get a lot of torque in there. This one's also capable of regenerative braking, kind of like the Toyota Prius and all the electric cars out there now. So if you like to take your foot off the gas, it starts slowing you down and turns this into a generator and pumps energy back into your batteries.
This is an event where students can actually build something and then go out and race it. And they've just done an incredible job. They think it's cool. They've put in incredible hours to make this happen. So this has been a great educational tool for them.
Yeah, I mean, it's a great opportunity because it's something that's new to Purdue, but it's something that's huge in the United States. You know, we're talking about green initiatives, about hybrid vehicles, electric vehicles, and it's something that has applications on such a large scale, even though we're applying it to this go-kart. You know, you see this in vehicles, buses, trucks, and who knows, maybe it'll go into aviation and other realms of the industry.
Purdue has a long-standing track record of providing top-quality engineers, and my company looks very highly at Purdue graduates. And we love being involved in the Grand Prix event today because it gives us an opportunity to give back to the university, to give back to the students, and give them something to look forward to after they graduate.
Last couple of turns for Brett Hensler. Here he comes down the front stretch. And Brett Hensler is your winner of the first Purdue Electric Grand.
All right, I'm here with Brett from Team Delta Sigma Phi Racing, and he just won the inaugural Electric Vehicle Grand Prix. How are you feeling, Brett?
Oh, it feels great. I mean, high speeds out here, everything, lots of teamwork. I mean, we put so much work into this that it feels great.
Okay, and what do you think was a factor in your win today?
I think driver skill, knowing this racetrack is huge. I've driven this a lot. I'm a Grand Prix driver, so I know the track, know the line. That shaves off a lot of time and keeps your kart efficient too, which is important for these.
Today's EV Grand Prix has been a huge success, increasing both public knowledge and popularity of electric vehicles. I'm Chris Nisley for Boiler Bytes.